Klopp tydelig irritert over at Curtis Jones kom skadet hjem fra landslagsopphold. Velkommen til pausepraten fredag 15. oktober ved Arve Vassbotten. Med en allerede tynnslitt midtbane kom Jørgen Klopp med svært dårlige nyheter på slutten av fredagens pressekonferanse. Curtis Jones er nemlig skadet og kommer derfor ikke til å spille mot Watford på lørdag. Klopp klarte ikke å skjule sin sarkasme da han snakket om dette på pressekonferansen.
By the way, when we talk about federation, Curtis Jones came back injured from the U21s. So great. Yeah, so that's not okay as well, but it's really difficult to get proper in contact with even with the English Federation because they just do what they want. Didn't train, was not involved in the first game. They didn't do a scan or whatever. Then he played a few minutes in the second game. What was the opponent? Second U21 games?
Andorra,
great. Very important that he played there. Came back, slight injury, not available for tomorrow. So these are the situations we have to deal with. And that's why we have these massive squads and can just use players like machines. You are not available, then we take you and stuff like this. I said it before, but when the federations don't start helping us, and I mean with them, all of them, whoever it is, the Premier League, the FA, they have to think about the game again and not only about their own interests. And that's how it is in a moment. But we can talk about that. I'm 6 years here and probably 7 years I talk about it. And it's just, it's always, you think, oh, why did we talk about it? Oh, it makes no sense. So, because nobody obviously is listening. And that's it.
Curtis Jones slet med et lyskeproblem på landslagssamlingen og sto over den første kampen, og i den andre kampen mot Andorra kom han inn som innbytter og leverte et kjempereid og målgivende til kampens eneste mål. Men den nye skaden betyr at Liverpool har få alternativer på midtbanen. Jordan Henderson, Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain, James Milner og Naby Keita er de eneste friskmeldte, og Klopp kan også vurdere å flytte ned Takumi Minamino. For Klopp bekreftet også på pressekonferansen at Alisson Becker og Fabinho ikke kommer til å spille lørdag. Brasilianerne sendes i stedet direkte til Madrid, der de skal bli til torsdag i neste uke. Liverpool gjorde et forsøk på å flytte kampen mot Watford til et senere tidspunkt på lørdag, men det var ikke Watford eller Premier League interessert i. Samtidig har Atletico Madrid fått utsatt sin kamp i helgen på grunn av den samme situasjonen. De vil altså få en frihelg før storkampen i Champions League på tirsdag, mens Liverpool må spille bortekamp tidlig lørdag.
The thing is that if they would obviously they could have flown in to England with all the quarantine stuff, then following up with that, that would have meant that they have to isolate from their families and stuff like this. And Ali has three kids. That's not a real, being already 12 days away with the national teams, then again 10 days in isolation, then 2 weeks here, the same rubbish again. So we need solutions for that, and they are still not there.
Brasil spilte i natt kamp mot Uruguay, og den var ferdig klokka 4:30 norsk tid. Fabinho var den eneste røde i aksjon, og han spilte 72 minutter. Alisson satt på benken i kampen som Brasil vant 4-1. De positive nyhetene fra Klopp på pressekonferansen i dag var at Trent Alexander-Arnold og Diogo Jota begge er klare for spill igjen. Thiago er imidlertid ennå ikke klar. På fredagens pressekonferanse fikk Klopp også spørsmål om hva han mener om kjøpet av Newcastle til Saudi-Arabia.
Yeah, I actually was waiting for some official statements about it, like from Richard Masters or somebody else. So, but because we all know there are obviously concerns about human rights issues, I think that's all clear that we all think the same there. What will it mean for football? That's few months ago, I think we had a massive argument issue. I would say the whole football world with 12 clubs or so trying to build a Super League, and rightly so, didn't happen. But this is kind of creating a super team if you want. It's pretty much the same. Guaranteed spots in the Champions League, not in a few years' time, not immediately, all these kind of things. With all the financial fair play is used nowadays, well, nobody knows exactly is it still existing or not, stuff like this. So it's like it is. So everybody knows that. Newcastle fans will love it, of course. but for the rest of it, it just means there's a new superpower in Newcastle. I cannot avoid that. Money cannot buy everything, but can over time, it will take time, but over time they will have... They have enough money to make a few wrong decisions, to make then the right decisions, and then they will be where they want to be. So that's how it is. I don't think that's to avoid in the long term.
Du har akkurat lyttet til Pausepraten det siste døgnet med Liverpool fra Liverpool Supporterklubb Norge. En nyhetssending som legges ut på alle hverdager. For flere nyheter, besøk liverpool.no.